absolutely certain, yes or no, did you see that train?
You're darn shooting I seen that train. It sure did go by my face.
That's all I wanted to know. Mr. Connelly, you're an operator at the Lone Pine Station, are you not?
Yes, I am.
And if I'm not mistaken, you were on duty the night of the 13th last month.
I was.
And heard an eastbound train. Is there any reason why you didn't hold 101 was coming west on a single track?
Because there was no train to hold. That's why. There ain't nothing eastbound after dark until 11:55. Unless it's a freight or a special. Your chief dispatcher can tell you that.
Mr. Conley, are you positively sure that...
Sure. Close that window, please.
Tell me, Mr. Conley, how do you account for not...
There was no train. I'd know if a train passed my tower, wouldn't I?
There was too a train. Mr. Harrington, I've been a railroad man all my life. When I see a headlight bearing down on me when I have the right of way, I know it.
You bet.
Yeah. Huh.
Nobody's doubting anybody's word. It's merely that the reports and testimonies have been conflicting to the point of improbability.
Tell us more in detail just what occurred, Nolan.
Well, we were rolling along about 60 miles an hour. Axel, my fireman here, had trouble with the oil pressure. When I turned back, there was a headlight bearing down on me at full speed. I gave my train all the air it could stand. Just had time to yell to Axel. That's all I knew till I woke up in the hospital.
Yeah, sure. And he was right there, too, Mr. Harrington. I saw the headlight. But when Smokey picked on the brakes, I pricked in your fly right straight into the fireboxes.
Yeah.
You can call it the goose train if you want. But it was a pretty good ghost that can race a bump like this here. You feel it, this hair. There is something the hardest hell had about, I can tell you.
Well, what are we stopping here for? Don't you know we're late?
I've got to go and see Dad, get the keys to the beach house.
I suppose you'll be all day talking to that rock-sized pornographer. Now, if you keep me
now,
waiting, I'll...
honey, don't get haunting of the Andres. I'll be back right away, as quick as you can powder your nose. And it needs it.
We've stopped at so many places since we started. I feel like I'm working on a milk route. All right, hurry up and get your keys.
Hello, Miss Gray.
How do you do, Mr. Harrington?
You tell my father I want to see him right away. It's very important.
I'm sorry, but he's very busy. They're holding an inquiry about the last wreck.
Wreck? Was there a wreck?
Of course.
Well, that's a shame. But there's nothing like a wreck to wear out an engine. I had to see him just the same way.
I wanted to keep everyone out of there, even you.
His own son?
Which one of these men is forward of your wrecking crew, Mr. Reynolds?
You are, I believe, Mr. Donovan.
Yes, sir.
Say, Dad, if you get the keys to the beach house, I want to get down there.
Why, then we...
Wait a minute.
Shall I question him, Mr. Harrington?
Yes, please.
Mr. Donovan, how soon after the wreck were you and your crew standing by?
About 2 hours.
I see. And did you make any investigation as to the cause of the wreck?
Well, I took a look around, but I didn't have much time to do any investigating.
Was there any evidence of another train having been there?
No, there wasn't, Mr. Harrington. But of course there wouldn't be. There was no collision. And railroad tracks is railroad tracks, Mr. Harrington. And all they show is the train can go over them.
Tell me, Donovan. Was there any identification that the track might have been tampered with?
No, sir. If there had been, I couldn't have told anyway. When the engine was derailed, it chewed up about 50 feet of track.
Perhaps the foreman of the road crew that repaired the track after the wreck might have observed something. Which one of these men is he, Reynolds?
He isn't here, Mr. Harrington. We won't be able to get in from his division until tomorrow. We were unable to reach him as soon as the rest.
Uh-huh. Well, send telephonic communication to get him here immediately. That'll be all, gentlemen. We'll postpone this inquiry until the other witnesses arrive.
Well.
me the keys to the beach house, will you?
Sailing yachts, padding tennis balls, golf balls, polo balls. I'm getting tired of it. If you were only a he-man yourself instead of a mere...
nincompoop.
Thanks. You'd be down here where you belong, trying to help me solve the mystery of these wrecks.
Dad, give me the keys now.
You'll be a mighty sight later before you get those keys. I can't find them. But even if I could, you're not going to get them. You understand? Now, that's fine.
Why are you going through your pockets? If you should find an extra 100, I could use that, too.
See here, young man. Before you get another cent from me, you'll settle down to business. Now, that is fine. Reynolds.
Yes, sir?
Reynolds, I've been looking at that letter again. A thought strikes me. Do you suppose those fellows that offered to buy our road, do you suppose that they could have had anything to do with these wrecks?
No. No, that's impossible. They're men of irreproachable reputation. I've investigated them very carefully.
Oh, I'm awfully sorry.
Oh, that's all right. Not half as bad as the last one.
Yeah. There's Hanson standing over here. Come on, and ask a priest. Swedish paints don't burn good.
I don't care what Hanson.
Come on,
now, Swedish paints do burn wood.
You just said don't burn
good. I tell Hanson.
Do they argue like that all the time?
You should hear him play Pinochle.
Well, I should love to. Would sometime this week be convenient?
Well, I don't think it would be for you. You see, Dad and I live at the other end of the division.
Oh, well, that's fine. Think I could come and see you, huh? Oh, I have to be going now. Or I'll probably meet with a serious accident. Goodbye, Miss Nolan. I'll be seeing you. So long. Dad, are you busy?
Of course I'm busy. What do you want now?
Nothing. Here.
Say, what's the matter with you anyway?
Nothing. Just bring him back to you, that's all.
What's the catch? What do you want now?
A job.
You mean... you... want to work?
Yep. Oh, I know. You're right, Dad.
Of course I'm right.
I ought to go to work. You know what I want you to do for me? Assign me to investigate these wrecks.
Fine. Fine. I'll send you out to the other end of the division. I'll write a letter to the superintendent...
Oh, no. Now, wait a minute, Dad. If I'm going to investigate these wrecks, let me do it my own way. I'll get a job at the roundhouse so nobody will know who I am. It won't arouse anybody's suspicion.
Say, wait a minute, wait a minute. Are you working for me or am I working for you? I'm not going to have any young...
Whippersnapper.
Whippersnapper telling me what... Say, will you please stop putting the words into my mouth?
But I want to handle this in my own way.
I tell you that every time I offer to say anything, you stop...
If they know who I am...
Well, all right. It's okay with me.
That's fine. Now, remember, you're Bruce Harrington from now on. And I'm your friend or something looking for a job.
Very well, my man.
And this letter will introduce you as Bruce Harrington.
Now, wait. The division head doesn't have to sweep up offices or dust off engines, does he?
No, I told you all you had to do. Not so worried, is it?
No, but it will be if your dad finds it out.
Oh, I beg your pardon. I'm awfully sorry.
Look out, look out. Watch your step. You ought to be able to walk down the aisle.
Boy, that was a good-looking girl. Did you see her?
I sure did. And I want to meet her, too. She's the daughter of Smokey Nolan.
Well, then you know her.
No, but we're going to know her. Listen, you breeze up and introduce yourself as Bruce Harrington, see? And the old man will be tickled pink. Then you can introduce me.
I'm beginning to see the advantage of being a railroad magnate already.
Sure, it's a cinch.
Yes, I'm Nolan.
Well, I'm Bruce Harrington.
Oh, Bruce Harrington.
My father's president of the road.
Oh, you're old man. You're Mr. Harrington's son. Well, I'm very pleased to meet you. How did you know who I was?
Oh, I've heard my dad speak of smoking oil
many, many times.
Is that so? Oh, pardon me. This is my daughter, Caroline. Mr. Harrington's son and president of the road. Says he's heard his father speak of me.
How do you do?
How do you do?
And this is my fireman, Mr. Axelson.
Oh, hello.
Pleased to meet you.
Won't you sit down? Well, yeah, you sit down, too.
Uh-huh. Didn't I see you in my father's office today?
Why, yes, I was there, but I didn't see you.
I wasn't there. Pardon me, folks. This is an old friend of mine, Mr. Eggplant.
What? What'd you say his name was?
Smith is the name. I'm very glad to know you, Miss Nolan. How are you?
My father, Mr. Smith, and
Mr. Smith. How do you do? Glad to know you.
You're traveling too, I see.
Yes. I'm on my way to see a pinochle contest. You play pinochle?
You bet, yeah.
I was the champion of Minnesota, too.
Yes?
Champion.
Bill.
Hi.
Sorry I'm late. The old woman again.
What's the matter? Doesn't the weather agree with her?
That's more than I could expect of any weather. Good thing I brought that lantern along. Can't see 3 feet ahead of you.
No moon.
Yeah. What's the setup? Everything on time?
Yeah. Everything but you. Hey, 101 lost 10 minutes at Morgan Hill. But he'll make that up before he goes by. Stay. When Smokey gets back on that run, we won't have to be worrying any about 101.
Speaking of Smokey, that guy testified at the inquiry that he saw a train coming right at him. What do you know about that?
Why, he's crazy.
They're calling it the Phantom Express.
Phantom Express.
A train is either a train or it ain't a train. This train ain't. And we're the guys that know it.
You're right.
Wait a minute, boys. They're changing shifts. Another guy lands it, you'll only have Red to take care of.
All right, okay.
Now, Nick's on the hot stuff. I don't want him blasted.
That's easy. Just a tap on the head and that's that.
That's another thing. I want this guy to see the Phantom Express. Wait a minute, boys. He's coming out.
Hey, Red. If you get lonesome, there's some ghost stories there on the desk.
Good night, Bill.
Good night, Red.
All right, boys, do your stuff.
Come on, Bob.
All right, and remember, no rough stuff.
Okay.
Hello, Lone Pine. Chief Dispatcher calling.
Okay.
Connelly speaking. Number 101 has right-of-way westbound.
Bound to the left 45.
Check.
Better hold that freight train on the siding still. 101 gets by.
Okay, Chief.
Okay.
Put up your hands. Don't move. Take your hand away from that switch. What?
Get your nerve, Slim. I'll take you.
It's all right.
Quit it.
Don't worry. Drop that gap. We can handle this baby all right.
Well, he can't fix it.
Darn it. It's all right, but get over there to the window quick.
Can you handle
yes,
that?
Okay.
Now, just relax a little.
Have a little impatience.
We'll show you the Phantom, all right.
Here you are, Buck.
by the way, you know where I can get a good room and board near the roundhouse at the end of the division, you know?
Near the roundhouse at the end of the division?
Yep.
Now, let's see. Oh, I'll have to ask Mother, of course. But you can stay at our house and share Jack's room. How would that suit you?
Oh, gee. That would be great, only Nolan might.
Oh, one more would tickle her to death.
My dear, I just imagine after the two awful accidents that you didn't know anything for a long time.
Oh, yeah. I was just this smart as before. Is your daughter enjoying the trip?
I guess she is. She's out there on the observation end with the president's son. Yes, sir, the president's son.
Hey, Chief!
I'll be a long time.
Hello, Connelly.
I just been held up and tied.
Stop saying about to go by.
Take it up and stop it. What about 101 coming west?
There can't be any eastbound train now. I think that's the hall bun, too. Talking to unless you did.
All right, Bruce. Don't be long, children. Supper's nearly ready.
All right.
Isn't it strange that you and Mr. Harrington are both called Bruce?
Yeah. Quite a coincidence. Is it all right for me to use these hangers?
Yes, that's all right, Mr. Smith.
Bruce is the name.
All right, Bruce. Have you any sisters?
Oh, me?
Mm-hmm.
No.
Surely you have some cousins.
Nope. Well, I have an aunt in Brooklyn. 90 years old today. Oh, dear.
And now that I have explained the technicalities to you, Mr. Harrington, you see why we really need this new system so badly.
Yes, yes, of course. Your technical points are very well taken, Callahan. But I wish you'd write this out on paper and I'll send it to the home office.
I'll do that, Mr. Harrington. But I wish you'd step down into the roundhouse and see how badly we really need this new water system.
Come on ahead, big boy.
Don't worry about us.
Let's see. Come on, honey. Come on, let her go. Oh, dear, dear.
Well, how big of a plant do you think we could install?
Oh, I should suggest that about 500,000 gallons a day would be sufficient.
Oh, let's make it 750,000. We'll put in a big plant.
Hey, you can't smoke in here. You get fired for less than that. Who, me? Ha, they can't fire me. Why, the foreman and I are just like that. That's me.
As you see, it's all right here. Now then, Mr. Harrington, if you'll come on inside, I'll give you my idea of what we should do.
All right, fine.
Now, as I said up in the office, Mr. Harrington, I have it all here on the blueprint. Mm-hmm. Now, you understand the technical terms, don't you?
Yes, yes, of course, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now, I figure that if we put the plant right outside of that wall, and run the pipes from one end of the roundhouse to the other, then we can put a lot of little pipes from the main pipe, which will lead into the stalls. Now, in doing that, we can eliminate a lot of boiler washing.
It's just what I said. That's fine.
Who did that? Hey, you! Come up out of there. Come on! Come on out of there.
Yes, sir.
Hurry up.
Oh, I'm awfully sorry, Mr. Callahan.
Yeah? Well, you get a piece of waste. Get down there and wipe off those shoes.
Oh, me?
Yes, you. Hey, Monahan, get some gasoline. Wait.
Hey, hey, that's the wrong shoe. Oh, I beg your pardon. Oh, come on, hired hand, make it snappy. Say, what do you think these pants are, a roller towel? Well, from what they're hanging on, I wouldn't know. Hey, what's that white-collared bird hanging around here for?
That's old man Harrington's son.
Well, that's the president's kid. He's learning the railroad business from the white pants down.
Well, it won't be many moons before the big bugs of this road get off their high horses.
Well, it ain't the moons that does it. It's the lack of moons.
Is the butter melted yet?
Mm-hmm.
Here it comes. Won't Daddy be surprised when he finds out Mr. Harrington's coming to his birthday party?
Lands, I hope those boys get home in time to get cleaned up before Mr. Harrington gets here.
Doesn't that look grand?
There. Well, here goes.
There now. Doesn't that look good?
Oh, it's lovely, Mother.
Here come the boys now.
Hello there.
Hello. Hi.
Oh,
what you got? Let me see.
Oh, no. Come on, Jack. You got to make it snappy now. He'll be home soon.
Yeah.
They didn't have a chance to test this train out. I hope it works.
Gee, it's a beauty, isn't it?
Oh, boy, look at that, huh?
Oh.
My dad gave me one of these when I was a kid.
He did?
I know. They burn wood like stove. I always knew you were a wood chopper.
Wood chopper? Wood chopper, nothing.
If you're not, you ought to be.
Listen, Smokey. A yoke is a yoke. And you're staring at the little bit before.
Hey, there's Smokey coming in.
Well, there's Smokey!
Hi, Bill.
Ben, I got some important business, Smokey. I shall be seeing you later.
Goodbye, old boy. Goodbye, old partner.
Yeah. Did you find out about those 3 o'clock in the morning?
Ah, nerd.
Thanks, Frank.
Hello, Frank. How's things?
Say, Smokey, here's a letter for you.
Oh, yeah. Thanks.
107. 36.
Hi, John.
Nolan again, Nero.
Crack engineer. Crack engineer. Crack Nolan.
Pulled out of the service. Pulled out of the service. Well.
What's the matter? Oh, what is it? Tell me, dear.
Pardon me, folks, just a minute. I better go see what's up. All right, a few minutes ago. What's the matter, huh?
I know what's the matter. An order came in from Reynolds to discharge Nolan on account of the wreck. You mean to say that he's fired? Yes, I didn't know he knew it. Listen, Bruce, I won't...
No, I'm through. So this is the way they treat a man who's given the best part of his life to the road, is it? Well, the dickens with the road, Dad.
Yeah, that's right, Smokey.
They
right,
can't boy. Do this thing to a man, Dad. It's not right.
I'll be all right, my boy.
Never mind, Smokey. We all know it wasn't your fault.
Here, take a look at this. Send a wire to Dead Knight and say that we'll have definite information for you shortly. Signed it, Bruce.
What information to you?
You got me, I don't know, but we're just playing a long shot, that's all.
Mr. Harrington!
My, that was a good dinner.
Mr. Harrington, my goodness, I think it was a shame the way Smokey was treated around here. Why, he was the best engineer on the room.
I'm sorry, but I had nothing to do with Mr. Nolan's dismissal.
No, but you was the president's son.
I'm sorry about all this, Miss Nolan. It puts me in a rather embarrassing position. Perhaps I'd better go.
Wait a minute, young feller. Do you think the Smokey was to blame for this?
I told you I had nothing to do with the matter. It'll have to be taken up with the Home Office. Good night, Miss Nolan.
Never mind, darling. Everything will be all right.
Well, I guess I can begin over again.
No, you won't have to.
Other fellows have done it, haven't they? Oh, yeah, dear.
Now, don't you worry, Carolyn. Everything's going to be all right. When they find out the real cause of the wreck, they'll reinstate your dad.
Suppose they don't find out.
Oh, but they will.
How?
Because I'm going to find out. And that's a promise.
Boy, it didn't seem like an hour to me. I think that clock's fast.
Well, you get used to it.
Your fingers get so sticky. You're liable to find it not so healthy around here. Can you imagine that guy making himself to home in my coat? Come on.
We better report this to the office.
Not yet. We've got to follow those birds tonight. But nothing. We're on the right track now. The track the Phantom Express goes down. Come on.
Mother.
Yes, dear. It looks all right. Now, if we only have enough for that other window.
Mother, I hardly think we have enough of this material. I think I'd better run down to the store and get some more. I'll be right back. I know I shouldn't have taken the liberty of coming here, and Dad would be furious if he knew, but he's so proud, and you see...
Carolyn. I mean, Miss Nolan. I'll do everything I can, and perhaps we can have him reinstated.
Certainly very kind of you, Mr. Harrington. I hope you don't think so.
Oh, not at all. I have to run down the street. Perhaps I can give you a lift.
Why, yes, if it isn't out of your way.
Well, I'd be delighted.
I certainly appreciate it. These are fresh offers you have.
Don't tell me. Look at it.
All right, I hope Slim was right, though.
That's him now.
Hit it?
Yeah. He's got a dame with him.
Oh, what's the difference? Come on, let's get him.
Okay.
I can't imagine what's keeping Carolyn. She just ran down to the store for a minute and she's been gone a lot. There she is now.
Axel.
Yeah, sure.
Why didn't you go out on 101?
Who, me?
Why, of course you. Who'd you think I meant?
Me? Excuse me, Mrs. Nolan. I tell you, Smokey, I was thinking it over. And if you wasn't good enough for the role, I wasn't too. So I quit.
You quit? You quit, I mean.
Yeah, sure. I wouldn't fire for any other engineer but you, Smokey. To heck with them and the railroad. But I tell you what we should do. We should jump in my car. We should go down and have a talk with the president, son.
Well, it wouldn't do any good. Besides, he wouldn't even see me.
Wouldn't see you? Why wouldn't he see you? Wasn't he here last night for dinner? Wasn't he? Come on now, Smokey. We should go down. Do this. Yes, go on for me,
well,
please.
Well, maybe you're right.
Come on, Smokey.
All right.
Come on, get along. Sit down, Charlie. Come out
of here.
You're not
going to
be hurt.
Come on, you won't be hurt.
Hey, wait a minute.
Oh, shut up and get in
there. Why'd they bring us way out here, do you suppose?
Shh.
Well, tell me.
In the first place, I'm not Mr. Harrington.
You're not?
Don't get excited. I'm a very good friend of his. Brooks asked me to take his place.
Ready to go?
Come on, come on. Let's get out of here. We ain't got all day, you know.
Thank you.
She's worried, that's all.
Listen, Dad. Bruce and I are on the trail of two birds who are working
now,
here.
Now, wait a minute. I was just talking with your mother on the phone, and she's awfully worried.
Caroline left the house at noon for a few minutes, and she hasn't come back yet. They just told me in the office that young Mr. Harrington left with her hours ago, and nothing been heard from her since.
Yeah, I don't see Al's car anyplace.
Well, I guess they got him all right.
Yeah. Come on, let's get in our car and get out of here.
We gotta get a car right away. We'll miss them. Take mine. It's at the warehouse.
Now, what's this all about?
Come on, I know where they are.
What's up? Hold on.
There they go. Come on, Dad. Hurry.
Wait a minute. Wait a
Come on, Mr. Nolan. Get in here.
Oh, what's it all about?
Come on, get in. We'll explain later.
Well, you give me the keys to your car, and I'll hurry back to Mother and Sam's.
Hurry up, Jackie, will you? Hey, there they go now. Let's wait here a minute.
Don't let them spot us.
My goodness, this sure is the lonely place around here. Say, Bruce, what is that they don't there?
Looks like an old barn.
Come on, let's go.
No. It'll be dark in about 20 minutes. We'll put off the lights and drive down there and surprise them.
But suppose they've got Sis and Harrington down there.
That's all the more reason why we should take no chances.
Yeah, that's them. Well, you got him, I see.
Yeah, him and his dame.
Hey, what's the idea?
She started to make a squad.
Not a bad looker either.
Looks to me like there are four of them.
Yeah. Gosh, sure. And there's four of them?
How do you figure?
You and Bruce is two, and me two. Two and two is four. The Phantom goes down the line tonight.
Oh, baby. Oh, but I best have us dark.
Come on in, I'll show you a gadget.
All right, come on. Oh,
what the dickens is that? Look.
What's that?
It doesn't sound like a car.
Well, I'm a son of a gun.
Oh, that's the Phantom Express, is it? Come on, go right down that road again now.
No, down the hill, it's quick.
Come on, let's go.
Give it to Axel, old boy, that's it.
I wonder who this geek is. Let's find out.
Well?
Excuse me, I was just looking for the main road.
Well, this ain't it. This is private.
Can't you read a sign?
Yeah, sure.
My, that's a good looking car. Is that your car?
Yeah, who wants to know? Scram.
Get him, Jack.
Well, it doesn't sound like a Sunday school picnic.
I think I'm losing my temper here.
Let me out of here!
Oh, that do no child of it.
Bruce! Let me out of here! Bruce!
Hey, wait a minute, I'll get you out here.
Come on.
Get up out of here. Here, get that dang in the car. Hustle along, will you?
All right.
Come on, get out of here. Make it snap enough. Come on, dear.
Come on, you fellas, on your feet.
Come on, get in that car.
Hurry up.
Come
on.
Go ahead, hurry up.
Get going.
Fellas, come on, get in there.
Dick.
Yeah.
I'll take Carolyn home. I'll meet you at the roundhouse. And listen, send Dad a telegram and tell him everything is okay.
Scram! Come on, get going.
Did you get that wire off to Dad?
No, I couldn't. The wires have been
down. Callahan, I've got to get a wire off to my father right away. It's important.
I'm afraid you're out of luck. You know, this storm has raised the dickens down the line.
No,
I'm sorry. Everything is down. Traffic is at a standstill.
Callahan, you've got to get me a crew. I'm going to get through tonight.
I couldn't take a chance. I wouldn't accept the responsibility to even attempt such a thing.
Little sort of shack.
Did you get a good look at these men?
Well, I halfway saw them, you know.
Would you know them again if you saw them?
Well, I think I would.
You can identify them, huh?
Yeah, I
Smokey,
so.
Smokey! Wait a minute, what are you talking about?
All the wires are down, the automobile roads are down, everything.
Well, what's that got to do with me?
Mr. Harrington's got to get the train 2-3-4 by midnight, and you is just the man that can do it.
You mean they want me to take a train through?
Yeah, sure, come on then.
All right, let's go.
You can't go out tonight, it's too wet.
Goodbye. Dad. Good luck, old timer. You've got 3 hours and 10 minutes to make a 4-hour run. But if anybody thinks getting there, you can.
Do it, Dad. Come on.
All right, take care, Caroline. I'll be right back.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Good luck!
We're coming to town!
Why can't you see it, Dad?
Can't see it yet!
I think it's Mendoza!
Mendoza! Now it's 10 minutes out, I'm gonna cut 15 minutes off my run now!
Say you can't get anything. Well, I've got to get a line through somehow. We're trying rerouting them.
You two fellas, let's go.
They said nothing could get through.
Farrell. You made it the old field. I told you so, didn't I?
Yes, you sure did. But it's not a sweet locomotive. We didn't burn any wood anyhow.
Oh, Smokey, lay off me, will you please?
Dad,
here I am.
Have you signed anything yet?
No, I haven't signed anything. How did you get through?
Smokey Nolan, I found out all about this gang. They're nothing but a bunch of crooks.
Why, what do you mean?
You know what I mean. You tried to swindle my father out of control of this road. Yes, they did, Dad.
Oh, don't talk nonsense.
I'm not talking nonsense,
Certainly
Dad.
You are.
They're a bunch of crooks, do you hear? Dad, Smokey was right. There was a headlight bearing down on him the night of the wreck.
There was?
Yep. You see, Dad, the Phantom is an aeroplane with a headlight on it. We saw their men go to the hangar, and when they opened it, there was a large plane with a headlight suspended between the landing wheels. And then they wheeled the plane out to test it, because they were going to run it tonight. As the plane took off, the noise in the motor stopped. We found they had a muffler on it. In the cabin of the plane was a 5-foot loudspeaker, which attached to an instrument board and amplifier that increased the sound 100 times. And through this, they played an electrical transcript, which sounded just as if the train were passing. The thing that fooled our signalman most was a column of smoke, which looked as if it was coming from a stack. They only run the Phantom on nights when there's no moon. It was impossible to tell it from a real train.
Are you sure of this, boy?
I'm absolutely sure, Dad.
Why, George, I thought this was a scheme. Arrest those men. They're swindlers.
More proof than my boy can offer me, and I'll take his word against yours every time.
Excuse me, Mr. Reynolds. But there's a couple of gentlemen not wearing the blue uniform. They're waiting to see you.
Yeah, you were. What do you mean?
Come on, let's go out there. Come on. Keep going out.
Well, we've been looking for you. Come on.
Oh, Smokey. Good boy, Smokey. You too, Axel. Fine work, huh?
I kill it, the team did